Vice President Leni Robredo has yet to decide if she will seek the country's top post next year. Robredo admits she is already conducting exploratory talks with personalities whom the opposition may consider as potential candidates. Among them, Manila Mayor Isko Moreno.
Merong mga initial na exploratory talks, not just with Mayor Isko. Not just with Mayor Isko, but with some other contenders. Hindi ko na muna sasabihin kung sino-sino kasi wala akong authority to say. Pero nandun kami sa usapan na exploratory. Ano ba yung mga commonalities natin na pwedeng pag-agrihan natin? And willing ba tayo na umupo?
The Vice President also sees room for improvement when it comes to her survey numbers. But she points out, poor survey ratings did not prevent her from winning the vice presidency in 2016.
Are you convinced and are you disheartened?
We look at survey results very seriously. Para sa akin, ano naman to eh, there's a lot of science behind it. I was relatively unknown. Ang gusto kong sabihin, my awareness ratings were down. So there was a lot of elbow room for me to improve my numbers.
In the event Robredo runs and wins the presidency, and President Duterte wins the vice presidency next year, she said she will treat Duterte differently.
I will not treat him the way he treated me. Kasi I don't think it is to the best interest of the people na yung presidente saka vice president nag-aaway. It's not as simple as giving him a cabinet post, pero tatanungin mo anong trabaho yung palagay niya he will be good at.
The president's spokesperson, Harry Roque, claimed Robredo left her positions in the administration.
Well, parang napakaikli naman po ng memorya ng ating vice president. Nakalimutan ba ho niya na binigyan po siya ng cabinet post ng ating presidente, pero mas pinili niya na maging leader ng oposisyon kaysa magtayo ng mga pabahay para sa ating mga kababayan.
But Robredo's spokesman points out, it was the Duterte administration that prevented her from fulfilling her functions as head of the government's Housing and Urban Development Coordinating Council when she was barred from attending cabinet meetings in December 2016. She was also fired from her position as anti-drug czar in November 2019, less than 3 weeks after her appointment. Robredo has yet to embark on consultations about the 2022 polls, similar to what the president's daughter, Sara Duterte, and the ticket of Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Tito Soto are doing. She says she'd rather focus on her work.
Tingin ko kasi napaka-insensitive natin sa pinagdadaanan na kahirapan ng mga kababayan natin. Kung sa gitna ng pandemic, ang naisip natin yung umikot.